all of you and welcome. I just wanted to share a little bit of insight for this Mercury retrograde in Cancer. There's so much information out there already, so I know that you're already very guided, which I think is amazing because we're starting to understand that this is a new language that we're creating and that we're aligning to in this golden age, in this Aquarian age. And it's all about understanding that we are interconnected with everything. We're cosmic beings. And when we align ourselves with these energies, magic happens, because Mercury is the messenger. The Greek god Hermes is Mercury, and he is the messenger. So when we go into this retrograde, it's 21 days usually, and in this retrograde, it's from June 18th until July 12th, and it's quite deep, because the first Mercury retrograde we had in 2020 was in February, and it was in Pisces. Now we have this one in Cancer, and the last one we're having is in Scorpio. So we're having these Mercury retrogrades in these signs of water. So there's a reason for this. So when I think about how we can navigate the Mercury retrograde and different retrogrades, I just think that the Mercury one is so important, because Mercury is about communication. And at the end of the day, it's not just about communicating with others through our voice, our words, and communicating our needs, our wants, our desires, and actually being able to have conscious communication with our parents, with our family, with our children, with our partners, with our co-workers, but it is about how the soul is communicating himself, herself with the world, with the external world, how we are allowing our soul to be in the body temple to communicate with the rest of the world. So that's why the Mercury retrogrades, I think, are very important, because they are more or less 21 days, and 21 is a very sacred number to the goddess, because it is an activation. So when we follow the Mercury retrograde, our communication as souls in this body temple on this planet will become more harmonious, and we will understand what are the blocks that are not allowing us to live in that conscious communication of the soul, being able to really be through the body and not just the personality that is the ego personality and the personality made up of constructs and programs and false ideas. So the first thing I just want to talk about is that it is a Mercury retrograde in Cancer, okay? And Mercury is very important this year. He was part of the conjunction of Pluto and Saturn in January. There was stellium, and he was involved in that. And so Mercury is the mind, Mercury's communication, Mercury's technology, new ways of communication, and again, soul communication. So what happens when we have Mercury retrograde in Cancer? This is very powerful, because on the 21st, we have the eclipse, the solar eclipse in Cancer. We have the Litha and the Yule, or the solstice. We have the new moon in Cancer, and we're going into the Cancer energy. Very powerful. Cancer is the mother. Cancer is nurturing. Cancer is love. Cancer is the emotional body, the emotional reality. So Cancer is your energy, has to do with your energy. Cancer is the connection to past lives, to the mystery schools, the guardians of the mystery schools. It's all about the womb. It's all about the moon. It's all about the phases. Cancer teaches us to expand and to contract, and to understand that there is a divine law of giving and receiving, and that there has to be a balance. Cancer is water. So this Mercury retrograde is very interesting, because usually Mercury retrogrades were asked not to start anything new or to sign any contracts. Now, it is always a tricky moment, because Mercury, it's almost as if the planet were still, because it pretty much is. So he's asking us to stay still in our communication and to actually be aware of everything that we are saying, everything that we are thinking, and the intention behind our words and behind everything that we want to do in life, our whole communication. I mean, even this morning, or actually I was preparing my new sadhana for Mercury retrograde in Cancer, and I didn't start 5 days ago, because you can usually feel the Mercury retrograde a few days before. And I was very aware of what I wanted to practice. I was very aware of what would be the sadhana that my daily practice in the morning that would make my body feel good and feel loved. It wasn't so much about, okay, I want energy for this, I want a meditation for that. It was more about, what does my body need to feel good, to feel loved, to feel nurtured, and to feel relaxed? Because at the end of the day, remember that Cancer needs to be emotionally secure so that she can expand. It's that mother moon energy. When the mother moon energy expands, it's our connection to the goddess Eve, which is the goddess of awakening. But to be able to do that, we need to be emotionally stable. We need to be emotionally balanced, and we need to feel good physically, and not just our body, but emotionally. So this is all about Cancer. So Mercury in retrograde in Cancer, like I said, we're usually asked not to sign anything or not to begin anything new. I gave the example of how much intention was put in my sadhana, because it is how I communicate myself to the world, the spirit world in the morning, and to my knees. So this is everything. You know, what are the decisions we're going to be making with our family? It's all about family, this Mercury retrograde. Not just your blood family, but your spiritual family as well. It's all about community. Do I feel as if I'm a community? Am I not in a community? It is also about the home. How can I make the home feel better? How can I make the home a beautiful place so I can really, really feel nourished in my home? And it's about past lives as well. Now, why I'm saying is that Cancer is creation. It is the creation in the womb. It's really the moment of ovulation. That's the energy of Cancer. Because ovulation is about creation and love. Actually, that's when women are more prone, right, to get pregnant, because it is about love. The body can tell you. So it is actually a wonderful time to deliver any creative endeavor. A project, a book, writing, amazing, a painting, of anything that is very creative. And also this Mercury retrograde is asking us to go into a state of creation, to understand what that means for us, but just for us. We don't have to share it if we want to, that's wonderful. But just for us, you know, how can we create, we can cook exciting meals, we can dance, we can create a beautiful home, we can change the furniture around. And the home is going to be a very big question this Mercury retrograde. A lot of you will probably feel like moving, or will probably feel like renovating the home, or moving city, or getting just doing something different with your home. Now, what stands out the most for me in this Mercury retrograde, apart from all of that, and I am Cancer, so I'm taking this very seriously, is that Cancer is a subconscious mind. Remember that. It's the moon, the subconscious mind. So it's all about behavioral patterns that are really, really ingrained in our subconscious that sometimes we just are not aware of because we do them every day and we don't take time to stop and see what our behaviors are, what our patterns are, and what are the things that we are attracting to our life. So this is a wonderful moment to really start a practice where you know that you're going to purify your subconscious mind. And to purify your subconscious mind, you need to release, but you need to replace that behavior with another behavior. And there are a lot, I mean, the subconscious mind is what controls us when we're not aware. I mean, we make decisions not out of spirit, out of this subconscious mind. So this is a very, very important message in this Mercury retrograde. And we do have 21 days to work on this. We do have different meditations that we can work with. And I'm going to share one with you right now that I really love to do. And it is about purifying addictive behavior. It's a very beautiful Kundalini yoga meditation. And I practice it every day. And we're going to do it for 3 minutes. And if you could do it for these 21 days, this is 3 minutes a day. And of course, on my YouTube channel, you can listen to the channelings that I give of Mary Magdalene. And you can do beautiful sacred dance and drumming and yoga. And there's so much that you can do. But we're going to focus on having something active, a tool that we can actually do every day to really purify our subconscious mind. Now, why am I giving you this for 3 minutes? You can do this from 3 to 5 minutes or even to 11 minutes, but 3 minutes a day is fine. Because I know that we are householders, that we work, that we have family, and sometimes we want to do the other stuff. We want to do the ritual, we want to do the writing, we want to do the healing, we want to do the creation, we want to connect with our past lives. And I will be posting a video on YouTube about a meditation on how to heal your lineage, because Cancer is about your lineage and accepting that lineage or going beyond the lineage. In this Mercury retrograde, we can go beyond the lineage. So I want to give you a lot of tools, because I'm fascinated by Mercury retrograde and all of these teachings that we can be aligned with to grow and to evolve and to connect with our soul contract. So, and you may know me by now, I really am, I think it's very important to align with a practice, because the body is the tool. The body is the tool that we have to elevate, to vibrate in a different energy. So we're going to do this meditation right now for 3 minutes, okay? And then I'll be giving you a few tips and different videos and what you can do, and maybe different rituals that I'll be sharing in my blog. And I will be sharing a beautiful sacred dance that you can practice as well. So let's start and do this meditation. I'm going to explain. We're going to put the thumbs here, and we're going to press our temples. You don't have to press hard. And we're going to vibrate the mantra Satanama mentally, which is infinity, life, death, and rebirth, the whole feminine cycle, the whole moon cycle, Mercury retrograde in Cancer. And every time we vibrate Satanama, we're going to bite in the back, in our molars, in the jaw, like Satanama, and we bite. I know it looks funny. You don't have to leave your mouth open. I'm just doing it so you can see me, okay? So let's do it together for 3 minutes. And we're going to begin.
Shalom, Shalom, Shalom.
just a little bit more. With the mother energy 3 minutes a day, and wow, I just feel really, really amazing after doing that. We're going to chant Divine Mother, okay? Let's chant the Divine Mother together. Divine Mother, receive our prayer. Retrograde to really connect with your emotional waters. We had the Mercury retrograde in Pisces in February, which are the cosmic waters, the psychic waters. This Mercury retrograde is your emotional water and the waters of love and creation. And then we have the last one in Scorpio, which will be quite deep. We'll get there. Thank you so much. Ahava. Thank you.